Tonight, another thundering verbal assault in the Senate spending showdown. Senator Mike Duffy says $90,000 was only part of the payoff.
One check from Nigel Wright? There were two checks, at least two checks.
Duffy's attack on the Prime Minister's inner circle intensifies. Evening, new revelations in the Senate scandal poured out again today, changing the story as we've come to know it. First, there was Stephen Harper with a major revision, saying his former chief of staff, Nigel Wright, didn't resign, but was fired over that $90,000 check to Mike Duffy. Later in the day, it was Duffy's turn again. He seemed to revel when he told the Senate he received a second check signed by the Conservative Party's lawyer to cover his legal fees.
The checks tell who's telling the truth and who is not.
He had a lot to say today in the Senate. Our coverage begins again tonight with CTV's Ottawa Bureau Chief Robert Fife.
Senator Mike Duffy had told friends he had another Scud missile to fire at Prime Minister Stephen Harper. He hit the launch button today.
One check from Nigel Wright? No, ladies and gentlemen. There were two checks, at least two checks. The PMO, listen to this, had the Conservative Party's lawyer, Arthur Hamilton, pay my legal fees.
A second secret check for $13,500, signed by the Conservative Party lawyer on instructions of Harper's former chief of staff, Nigel Wright. Money the Conservative Party now confirms came from the Tory rank and file. In May and again in July, the party told CTV News its funds were not used to help Duffy. Today in an email, a different story. At the time these legal expenses were incurred and paid, Mike Duffy was a member of the Conservative Caucus. The Conservative Party sometimes assists members with legal expenses.
This was secret money paid for by people who in good faith gave money to this Prime Minister.
That money is on top of the $90,000 check Wright personally wrote to pay off Duffy's improper living expenses. Duffy alleges the whole scheme was orchestrated by Harper despite his public denials.
This was all part of his strategy, negotiated by his lawyers and the Conservative Party's lawyers to make a political situation embarrassing to his base go away. Are we independent senators or PMO puppets?
This confirms what Canadians are increasingly beginning to believe, that Mr. Harper has enormous difficulty telling the truth.
Duffy says many people at the highest levels of the PMO were involved in the charade to convince the public he paid the 90 grand out of his own pocket.
So we decided last night to turn the page, pay the money back.
Even rehearsing with him lines he was told to deliver on TV and telling Canadians he borrowed the money from the Royal Bank.
This monstrous fraud was the PMO's creation from start to finish.
Wright, Duffy says, manipulated a Senate committee, whitewashing a report on Duffy's expenses. Duffy also tabled an email from Wright showing the heavy-handed way he dealt with then-Senate leader Marjorie LeBreton. She had gone along with a Liberal proposal to require all senators to produce proof of residency. I had no foreknowledge of it. When I learned of it, I asked for all unilateral action from that office to cease before being cleared with me.
What's right is what you can get away with, and what's wrong is what you get caught doing. That seems to be the way Mr. Harper runs the government of Canada.
Duffy insists he was well within the rules of filing his expenses, and the true amount of his invalid claims is less than $500.
The Prime Minister's office insists Harper wasn't aware of the backroom dealings and wouldn't have approved of the scheme that involves at least 13 senior Conservative insiders. Lisa.
Now, it may bear repeating here, Bob, that Mike Duffy was chosen by the Prime Minister back in 2008 and now, again today, seems to be on a mission to bring him down. It was quite a show there today. Does he have any cards left to play?
Well, Lisa, Senator Duffy is hinting to friends that he does have more bombs to drop, and that's a big, big problem for Stephen Harper. He's become a hostage of Mike Duffy. Insiders say when CTV first broke the story back in May, Harper should have come forward, put out all the ugly details and being honest with Canadians. Now he's the victim of what some people describe as Duffy-style waterboarding. And you can be absolutely sure the Prime Minister's office now knows all the details, but for some reason, they aren't telling Canadians. And that's what the opposition parties are asking, why not?
Duffy-style waterboarding. Very colorful, Bob. Thanks for this tonight. Before the bombshells in the chamber went off, Conservative senators had a meeting behind closed doors to talk about how to punish Duffy, Pamela Wallin, and Patrick Brazeau. According to a new Ipsos Reid poll commissioned by CTV News, most people across the country have already made up their minds. 73% of Canadians want the three senators immediately suspended without pay. CTV's Danielle Hamamjan has more on how Canadians are viewing this political fiasco and more on how Harper repackaged the departure of Nigel Wright.
The questions will just not go away.
Which version of the events are true?
Which version of Nigel Wright's departure is true? Did he quit or was he fired? During a radio interview, the Prime Minister changed his story.
As you know, I had a chief of staff who made an inappropriate payment to Mr. Duffy. He was dismissed.
Keyword, dismissed. That's not what he or Wright have said since day one. In May, Wright wrote that in light of the controversy surrounding my handling of matters involving Senator Duffy, the Prime Minister has accepted my resignation as chief of staff. That same day, Harper said, it is with great regret that I have accepted the resignation of Nigel Wright. 4 days later.
He should have told me earlier. That's why I accepted his resignation upon.
He said it again.
He offered his resignation and I accepted that resignation.
And again just last week.
And he has resigned.
Whichever version is true, according to a CTV News Ipsos Reid poll, it appears only one in three Canadians approve of the way Harper has handled the Senate scandal.
Who knew about the check?
That, of course, remains the big question. Who knew what, and more importantly, did the boss know? Until now, Harper says he was in the dark.
Any suggestion that I knew or would have known is incorrect.
But ask Canadians. 65% of people do not believe Stephen Harper when he says he did not know about the Nigel Wright check to Mike Duffy.
We've got a lot of people tuned into this story and watching this as a melodrama, but the reality is that the vast majority have already made up their minds in terms of how the story is going to end.
So the majority of Canadians believe suspension without pay is how it should end for Duffy and the two others. It appears 80% of Canadians believe there should be a public inquiry into the Mike Duffy, Nigel Wright scandal. Lisa.
80%. Okay, Danielle Hamamjan, thanks for this tonight from Ottawa. Also, the spending scandal is focusing a lot of attention on the inner workings of the upper chamber. We have all the Ipsos Reid poll numbers on our website if you want to check that out.